Paul Rudolph was a key figure for post-war American modernism, celebrated for his experimentation with new materials and his virtuoso ability to sketch a new building in minutes. Whether it was a Florida beach house or a massive civic center, Rudolph's architecture expressed the optimism and confidence of America at mid-century. Rudolph's true masterpiece, the Yale Art and Architecture Building, was a very personal endeavor, as the building was to house the department he himself chaired. After one false start and much agonizing, the project was completed in 1963. The A&A building was a virtuosic display, heralded as the solution to modernism's major problems. But by the late 1960s, opinion turned against him. His once acclaimed large-scale concrete buildings became despised as symbols of authority. To make matters worse, in 1969, a mysterious fire, rumored to have been set by disgruntled students, devastated the A&A building. By the 70s, his architecture was thought to represent everything wrong with modernism. Though hurt by the criticism, Rudolph continued to design with ingenuity into the 1990s. His tall buildings in Asia, designed during his final years, even anticipated today's green building practices, including open-air corridors, lush plantings, and sunshades for natural cooling. The Architecture of Paul Rudolph is the first comprehensive study of the designer's work that follows the arc of his journey from forward-thinking outsider to Yale educator to scapegoat, then finally achieving his place as an upholder of modernism.